Well, yeah, maybe the solution's been around for decades and decades and decades. Let's just have one country where Jews and Palestinians live equally under the law, same law. And, that's another way of solving the problem.
Right.
But again, we're not further down the road either of those two possibilities at this stage. And, although the Biden administration says they would like to go back and, pull out the old dusty final say we'd like a two-state solution, please. But again, who wants to talk about that right now in Israel? Hardly anyone.
Now Tully's trying to do something. He said he wants to reduce friction with the Palestinian Authority and improve living conditions, in the Israeli-occupied West Bank.
Yeah.
And it looks like he also wants to provide some economic changes, which will, of course, benefit Israel.
Yeah, well, again, and then the other thing is, too, is an altruistic, a better relationship with Abbas and the Palestinian Authority of the West Bank means that they strengthen that card whereby, you may not see Hamas growing as they did in Gaza. So they don't want that to happen in the West Bank. So you try to keep, the Palestinian Authority a bit sweeter and do what you can to keep them off of out of the West Bank.
All right, well, Tom, thanks a lot. It's one of these stories that just doesn't seem to change.
Very much so.
Somebody's playing music for us. It doesn't seem to change, but, we're going to keep on. There's always a lot of interest in it, and I appreciate you keeping your eye on it for us. We'll talk later. The parents of the 14-year-old girl who was accidentally shot and killed by police in North Hollywood are demanding transparency while the shooting is investigated.
The girl's mother says her daughter was shot as the two were hiding in a dressing room. An attorney for the family read a statement from the girl's mother detailing the moments her daughter was shot.
Her body went limp. I tried to wake up by shaking her. But she didn't wake up.
Attorneys for the girl's family say they want all of the evidence around the girl's killing to be made available. They say they believe there is more video than what has been released. In downtown L.A., Blake Trolley, KFI News.
Uh-oh, this might be a bad mom. The TSA in Philadelphia says a woman and her young son were trying to get on a plane with two knives, but they were sewn into the middle of a stuffed Darth Vader bear. This happened on Monday. Of course, they x-rayed it and it showed something hidden in there, and officers say that they noticed that the bear had been restitched and that two knives were, as they put it, artfully hidden inside in the middle of the bear's stuffing. The woman told the TSA that the bear was a comfort toy for her son, and she is likely to face a fine or some other federal civil penalty. Despite reviews, we've heard this before, we've talked about it a little bit, but we've never really gone into detail. Steven Spielberg's West Side Story has failed to gain traction with audiences at the box office. Box office analysts say it suffered because it was targeted at older audiences who are kind of hesitant to return to cinemas during the COVID pandemic. And it also lacked a major star and Spider-Man No Way Home. It only made $36 million so far, but the production budget was around $100 million, not including marketing costs. And the chief analyst for boxoffice.com says West Side Story was largely a victim of timing and inability to attract younger moviegoers because the target audience is women over 35, and they like to go to most musicals, but they don't really like to go out and get exposed to the possibility of getting COVID, apparently. This is KFI and KOST HD2 Los Angeles. From the Southern California Toyota Traffic Center, we make it easy. Out to the crazy drive we go, crashing Corona. No, it's Jeff Bog, KFI in the sky.
There you go.
That crashing Corona, maybe you can go look at it for us sometime.
That's all gone, but I'll tell you what. Number one, and good morning to you. If you're coming, well, let's say it's going to drive to 134 westbound, coming out of Pasadena through Glendale, Burbank, right by the KFI studios. And continue. There was a crash in order to clear this as well. We just want to confirm it for you if you had to leave for a while. Westbound at Laurel has a whole bunch of lanes blocked.
Go
ahead.
Drive
past Pasadena, over to Toluca Lake, and it's all good. Now, I want to warn you about something. I'm just reading the CHP notes on this. It says northbound 170 at Sheldon. That's up at the 175 merge. It says a dog crate blocking two left lanes. I hope there's not a dog inside it, but just be careful if you're approaching. Chris, as I speak to you now, I bet you used this on-ramp. Eastbound 134 at Buena Vista, there's a car sitting there with its flashers on, so just be careful if you're about to get on. Other than that, drive is good. Injured in accident, visit Superwoman, Superlawyer.com. Jeff Ball, KFI in the sky.
Usually the holidays are almost here. When you think about that, what's the first thing that comes to mind? For me, it's the smiling faces of friends and family as we celebrate together. I'm Larry Green of System Perry, America's number one designer and installer of elegant outdoor living systems. Today, I'd like to help bring a smile to you and your loved one's faces, too. For a limited time, System Pavers is sharing our exclusive friends and family pricing. This is your chance to save big on an outdoor makeover that will make every get-together more memorable than ever. From a new patio or fire pit to upgrading your driveway or entry, take advantage of the low prices during our Home for the Holidays friends and family savings event. Get started right now by calling 800-PAVE-004. That's 800-PAVE-004. Hurry, this exclusive friends and family pricing won't last forever. 800-PAVE-004 or systempavers.com.
All orders must be placed by December 31st, and installation must commence within 60 days of sale. Financing subject to third-party approval. See website for full offer details. Contractor license 661575.
If you're tired of big cable bills, you can get Newsmax TV for free. Millions are watching Newsmax, available now on major cable systems or for free on smart TVs like Samsung, LG, and Vizio. Find it streaming on Roku, Sumo, Pluto, Amazon Fire, TiVo, Apple TV, and more. 7 million Americans have downloaded the free Newsmax app on their smartphones. It takes just seconds, then watch us anytime, anywhere. Forbes calls Newsmax a news powerhouse. Find out why. Start watching today.
Southern California weather from KFI. Rain today. Highs in the mid to upper 50s. Cooler in the valleys and the Inland Empire. Rain and a chance of thunderstorms tonight. Right now in Burbank, it's 47. West Hills, 40. It's 45 in Fullerton, 45 in Anaheim. We lead local live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. I'm Chris Little. This has been your wake-up call. Handle on the news is now.
Handle on the news.
We are seeing.
Tyler, cut the music, please.
Fast.
Well,
what's wrong?
Has this ever happened to you? Everybody here uses headphones regularly.
Oh, yeah.
Have you ever done the, you know, you pull your headphones apart a little bit to put them on your head? You ever pull them apart and as you're putting them towards your head, you lose grip on one ear cup and it snaps back into your eyeball?
Yep.
It has happened to you?
Yeah.
Okay, I mean, I don't mean thank goodness that it happened to you, but thank goodness if I'm not singularly some kind of freak.
Yeah, well...
Wow!
Oh, man.
That's smart!
You got your hand covering your left eye.
Oh, no, it hurts!
Yeah, no, I can tell. I thought you were going to say you had a migraine and you had to go home.
No.
Oh,
okay,
yeah, that
I
hurts.
Can see,
and
I can see. Smacks. Everything's fine.
It smacks hard.
Yeah, wow. That's not professional.
Yeah, they're tensioned. They have springs in them, basically.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
All right, so, good morning. This is the Bill Handel Show.
KFI AM 640, everywhere on that iHeart Radio app. People listen to this radio station from all around the world. So a great good morning, good afternoon, good evening, good middle of the night. wherever you might be. Bill is off this week. Chris Little is here for the vacationing Jennifer Jones leave.
Oh, yes.
Now a proper good morning to you.
And good morning to you, Wayne. It's good to be here.
Ooh, my eye's throbbing.
It's actually throbbing.
I can hear it.
Not good.
How are you, though?
I'm doing well. Thank you.
Let me ask you something, because you're a polite man.
So I didn't want to
jump in at the time, but Jeff Baugh, I felt like Jeff Baugh might have been getting a little presumptuous when he said, oh, Chris, you've used this exit, the 134 Buena Vista over here.
Uh-huh.
And in my head, I'm like, I don't know if that's the exit he uses. Why are we assuming something? So let me just ask you, was he correct that you do use that exit, or was he wrong?
He was incorrect.
I have
used that exit, but I do not use that exit, especially in the morning, and usually never.
There you go.
But I have.
And this is a lesson about, let's broaden this out into an ABC afternoon special.
Yeah.
After school special. You never, ever, ever assume things about other people.
No.
Whether it's what exit they use frequently, or trying to infer something about their character from the color of their skin.
How they vote.
Or what else you might discern about them based on how they vote.
Exactly. Yeah.
I remember one of these interminable cross-country drives that I took with my family when I was a kid. Every summer, this was the vacation. You got into the station wagon. You drove across country, usually 4 days, I think, to do it.
I remember.
And then visit the family.
Mm-hmm.
The you know, my dad's parents in Michigan and my mom's parents in, depending on which year it was, the D.C. area or also in Florida. Anyway, one time, we're in the middle of the desert, and something happened to the car. I think it was just a tire thing.
Mm-hmm.
So we're stopped, and then some couple stopped and helped. All I did was sit in the back of the station wagon.
Sure.
Wishing that I didn't have to sit in a car for 4 days. Anyway, so some couple pulled in and helped or whatever, and then we're driving away. And my dad made this big point. Obviously, it made an impression, because I still think of it from time to time. And he basically said, you never assume anything about someone or judge someone because of their race or whatever. And I don't remember, the people that stopped to help us must have been a minority or something.
Oh,
I don't know if they were black. I don't know, maybe they were Native American. I don't know what it was. But his point was like, they're good people of all kinds and don't ever, you know, and other people may try to tell you that certain kinds of people are bad.
Yeah.
And that don't ever do that.
It's a good lesson. Let me give you one real quick. I don't want to diverge too much, but we go to church, and I am a declined estate as far as my political beliefs go.
Okay.
And I am really honestly straight down the middle because of all the years of being a journalist. I don't really care. But my wife is a Democrat. And somebody at church found out she was a Democrat and said, I can't believe you can be a Christian and a Democrat because of your support for a woman's right to choose. So you cannot assume. And that made a huge impression on our entire family. Oh, my goodness. And this is a friend.
Are they still a friend?
Yeah.
You know, because after saying something that stupid?
Yes.
Wow. Well, yeah. You have a high tolerance in the little household.
Yeah, we're like, yeah, whatever.
The foibles of your friend.
Yeah, it's something to talk about. It's a good party story.
Yeah, wow, that's crazy.
Yeah.
Also, by the way, she found out your wife was a Democrat.
Yeah.
So that would just be really her voter registration status?
Right.
As a Democrat. Was there also a specific discussion about abortion rights?
No.
Or was it a double assumption? If you're a Democrat, you must support abortion, which is not necessarily true, even.
Right.
And then how can you be Christian?
Okay, and then the other one is, how can you be Christian and support abortion, right? Which is possible. Of course it's possible. And also, there's a difference between, I mean, to say support abortion,
right,
makes it sound like, hey, people should get abortions.
I said it the wrong way.
I wish there was a way men could also get abortions. That's how into abortion I am.
Yes.
I'm going to file a lawsuit. That men are not allowed to have abortions. It's gender discrimination.
Well, make it a class action. I'll get in on it.
You might support the idea that that's an issue, that's an individual decision as opposed to a government criminalization.
Yeah.
It doesn't mean you support it. You can despise abortion, but still recognize that it's not a tenable thing to make people who want one criminal.
Exactly, yeah.
You can still say abortion is terrible. Every abortion, unless it's medical, if it's medical, like you're having a pregnancy and you want to carry the baby to term, and then something happens medically and to save your life or whatever you have to do, putting those aside, and I rape and incest, I guess, falls into this category, but the classic, just, I didn't want to get pregnant, but I got pregnant.
Right.
Theoretically, you can look at that and say every abortion is a failure of proper behavior.
Perhaps.
And
yeah.
results in the killing of a life. And still believe that the government has no business turning people like that into criminals.
Right.
So, that's kind of, I don't like, whoever this person is, they're still your friends. They're not my friends. They will not be my...
Yeah, it's just a hard line view, I guess. And, you know, what you do with people like that is you just don't discuss it.
Yeah, exactly.
There's a lot of other things we can laugh about. And I mean, we don't see those people that often, but, you know, there's a lot of other things we can have fun with. And we just leave that one alone.
Stay away topic.
Yeah, but it certainly was an eye-opener for me and my wife.
It's very reductive. It's very reductive, and it's very it's based entirely on there's one group of people, my group, and there's another group of people, and they're the enemy.
Well, you also can't make an assumption of the religion either, because, you know, these are Christians, and that is just their point of view.
Put
and
an Episcopalian in a room with a Southern Baptist.
Right. There
they're
you go.
Both Christian,
yeah.
And yet if you hear them talking, you'd go like, oh, this is two completely different religions in this room.
Yeah, no, it's deep. It can get deep.
Yeah. Good morning, Alex.
Oh, good morning.
Anything you want to add to the discussion?
No, I'm pretty good.
Oh, come on.
Okay. No, don't force people to talk if they
don't. No, I'm just goading her. I'm not forcing her.
Where's that line?
That's very...
I'm not forcing you. I'm goading you incessantly.
Yeah.
I'm not forcing you. I don't have a weapon in my hand. Tyler, good morning.
Good morning, Wayne.
Anything you would like to add?
I think a break sounds fantastic.
We will continue with Handle on the News after a news update from Chris Little right here on KFI AM 640, live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app.
All right, Wayne, rain and snow is going to make a dramatic return to Southern California today, dropping up to several inches of rain over the next 2 days and bringing a few feet of snow for people in the mountains. Shout out to Mount Baldy. The long-feared spike in hospitalizations due to COVID-19 may be materializing in Southern California health facilities, and President Biden is revoking travel bans on 8 countries in Southern Africa. We'll have a look at your 210 with the KFI in the Sky next.
If you want out of your house, moving, downsizing, you have financial issues, maybe you've inherited, so you list it with a broker, and that means hours of cleaning and painting and repairing and paying big fees. So let me give you another way of doing it. You get a fair price without any of that. Buyer never walks through your house. There's never an appraisal, no commissions, and you can get paid in cash within 10 days or less if you need it. That's directbuyers.com. That's the company that Janet and Matt, brother and sister, own, and I love the way they do business. They'll never lowball you. They're just honest folks. And let me tell you, a lot of schmucks in this industry, and that's not what they are. They'll give you an honest, no-obligation offer and even offer a $15,000 cash advance before closing. Go to directbuyers.com. That's directbuyers.com. Call 844-242-SELL. 844-242-CELL-DirectBuyers.com.
It's better breakfast o'clock at Wendy's, because it all starts with a better biscuit. Get hot and buttery Wendy's breakfast biscuits made with oven-baked bacon or savory sausage, fresh cracked egg, and cheese. So don't risk your biscuit. Get Wendy's instead. Limited time only at participating U.S. Wendy's.
Rain today, highs in the mid-50s to upper 50s. Cooler in the valleys and the Inland Empire. Rain and a chance of thunderstorms tonight. This report brought to you by Wendy's Hot and Buttery Breakfast Biscuit Sandwich. It looks like we've got some problems on the 210, Jeff.
Well, you betcha, but I'm happy to tell you that it's on the eastbound side, a little bit before Sunflower. We're looking at it right now. It's over to the shoulder, just some flashing lights. So you drive the important stuff now, eastbound especially, from the 605 out towards the 57. It's all looking good. Even westbound now, there's a lot of volume coming in towards the 605, but from the 605 into Pasadena, it is looking good. We're just making a turn right now. We're going to head to the 91-605. There's a little bit of an issue that's popping up now on the westbound side at the 605. I'll check that for you. But other than that, our entire freeway system is really looking good here this morning. A little bit of slowing coming through the Newhall Pass, that's to be expected. But there are really no big deals anywhere. Let's keep it that way for a while before the rain comes. Injured in an accident, visit superwomansuperlawyer.com. Jeff Baugh, KFI in the sky.
This report is sponsored by Caltrans and the California Office of Traffic Safety. Hey drivers, if you've had marijuana or pills that may impair, invest in a sober ride. It's worth it. Whatever you do, don't let high or prescribed drive. Go safely, California, from Caltrans and the California Office of Traffic Safety.
If holiday music turns your joy all the way up to 10, then SiriusXM is your home for the holidays. From traditional and country to pop, soul, and so much more, SiriusXM has exclusive holiday channels dedicated to the music that makes your season bright. Listen in the car on the way to the party, or in the living room as you're wrapping presents. Visit SiriusXM.com/listenholiday for how to start listening.
Welcome in the new year with dazzling deals from Stater Brothers Market. Fresh boneless flat meat, great for carne asada, is just $6.99 a pound. At these prices, guacamole is a must. Avocados are 2 for $1. Roma tomatoes are 2 pounds for $1. And 1 pound bags of limes are only 99 cents. Perfect with 36 packs of Budweiser and Bud Light, or 24 packs of Michelob Ultra or Bud Light Seltzer for just $19.99. Here's to a happy new year from Stater Brothers Market.
Hi, Tim Connell here of Connell Chevrolet Costa Mesa. Find your cash, find your deal, and enjoy $500 in red tag bonus cash on select new Chevys at ConnellChevrolet.net. Find new roads at Connell Chevrolet, the Orange County original since 1964.
Right, let me tell you about Sunday. All right, my friends, it's Sunday. They can sell your home fast with no repairs, no hassle of showings, realtors, cleaning, or making upgrades. Sunday, they are the best, right? And they have free no-obligation cash offer. They're going to visit your property, do a 3D walkthrough, and they package all the property details up, send it to thousands of local investors. And then over the next week, the average homeowner receives 12 offers on their property. It's like a mini bidding war going on your property. It's quick and easy. Then they can close in as quick as 10 days. That means you can be out before Christmas. Maybe up to Boise, Idaho, right? A huge ranch up there. You may also be eligible for a $10,000 cash advance. So look, phone them up. 825 offer. 825 offer, or the website is sunday.com, sundae.com. Send you California licensed real estate broker, DRLS number 0208829.
Owen Patterson and Owen, proudly representing Angelinos for over four decades. $10 billion recovered for accident victims. LA's award-winning law firm. Free consultation at 888-OPO-WINS. 888-OPO-WINS. OPOLaw.com.
If you're tired of big cable bills, you can get Newsmax TV for free. Millions are watching Newsmax. Available now on major cable systems or for free on smart TVs like Samsung, LG, and Vizio. Find it streaming on Roku, Sumo, Pluto, Amazon Fire, TiVo, Apple TV, and more. 7 million Americans have downloaded the free Newsmax app on their smartphones. It takes just seconds. Then watch us anytime, anywhere. Ford calls Newsmax a news powerhouse. Find out why. Start watching today.
Hi, I'm Danny McKenna, McKenna BMW in Norwalk and South Bay BMW in Torrance.
You haven't heard me on the radio for a while because we haven't had enough cars to sell. But that's all changing. With two BMW dealerships serving LA and Orange County, we have a great selection of new BMWs. In fact, if you don't see what you're looking for, it's either on its way or we can special order and deliver it to your door. The days of walking through 1,000 new BMWs are gone, but finding exactly what you want in McKenna BMW or Southgate BMW is here to stay. Visit McKennaCars.com or stop by the dealership nearest you. You're going to thank me.
Hi, we're home. This is Dr. Robert Lewis. He's a neurosurgeon at Pickup Family Neurosciences Institute who loves camping with his daughter. He is also a nationally recognized expert in minimally invasive brain tumor surgery at home. Dr. Lewis would love to get to know you and is ready to make a positive difference in your family's life. Get to know Hoag. Visit hoaghealth.org and find your physician today.
As 2021 comes to a close. Get ready to celebrate the Year in Music. We came here to have a good time. On our 2022 iHeartRadio Music Awards. Ready, iHeartRadio, at Tulsa Live. Coming back to Fox March 22nd. Oh, man. Live from Los Angeles. iHeartRadio Music Awards. A little bit different. Are you guys ready? Where your favorite artist will go home winners. And the iHeartRadio Music Awards. Thank you. Our 2022 iHeartRadio Music Awards.
Sideline the panic. Sideline the this is nothing. And just be sensible.
Figure out who in your life you think is going to be the most vulnerable.
Make sure that you have a hedge of protection around them for this thing.
Be careful.
Gary and Janet.
And then go live your life.
Weekdays at 10 a.m. on KFI.
Live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app. Good morning. Bill Handel Show. Bill on vacation this week. It is time to start Handel on the News with Chris Little in for Jennifer Jones Lee. Lead story. John Madden has passed away at the age of 85. Legendary coach, legendary broadcaster, legendary pitchman. Legendary, very interesting guy, and legendary, like a real cultural icon. Yeah, and you know what? I loved his humor, and I loved his voice. Well, at 7 o'clock, we're going to talk more about his fascinating career, why he quit coaching at the young age of 42, even though he was doing great. He still holds the highest win percentage of any NFL coach who has more than 100 games under their belt.
That's pretty amazing.
And I also have found a couple of audio clips that I'm going to want to play to show, in one case, his sense of humor while he was doing the job of being the most beloved television football analyst in the country at the time. And then another clip that showed how he could integrate himself into almost any kind of setting.
Yeah, hey, he was great at not being mean, but teasing players.
Yes. He had such a gentle, he had a gentle sense of humor.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, great guy, 7 o'clock, more about the amazing John Madden.
All right, another legend, Harry Reid, Nevada's longest-serving member of Congress, has died. He was 82, and it's interesting. I'm always fascinated when people of that age, you know, over their 80s, have like a four-year battle with something like Harry Reid did, pancreatic cancer, and that's what takes them down. You know, not like natural causes, but he probably would have lived to be 100.
Yeah. And he survived for 4 years with one of the most virulent, deadly cancers that we know. You know what's interesting about Harry Reid? A couple of things. One, he was... Antisocial is the wrong word. He was famous for declining virtually every social invitation that he was given. Usually for some kind of party. You know, what D.C. is just a party town. Not a woohoo party town,
right.
But let's all show up at a lobbyist hotel suite party town. And he would almost always say no and even joke about it on the floor of the Senate. And the other thing about him is, and I would like to do a dramatic recreation with your help,
yes,
Chris Little. He was famous for another habit that he had. So,
answer. Let us pretend we are on a phone call. That you can be whatever other senator you would like to be. How about if I'm the president? Oh, okay, fantastic. You're the president. I am Senator Terry Reed. Yes. We're going to have a quick phone call here. And you'll see he had a habit, and he was famous for this habit. All right, here we go.
Hello, Harry. This is Barack.
Oh, Mr. President, how are you? I wanted to talk to you about bill number 1537 and a timeline for getting the vote going on that.
Well, as you know, that one is near and dear to my heart, and I really would like to get things taken care of on this. I'm just having a little problem with you.
Ah, well, here's what I propose. Next week on Tuesday, maybe we can get it out of committee and get it to a floor vote by Thursday. What do you think about that?
I don't think I like that idea. I think what we need to do is speed it up a little bit, Harry. Are you hearing me?
All right, well, what if I get it to the floor Tuesday afternoon? After it gets out of committee.
How about the Tuesday morning, Harry? You hearing me?
Well, I'll tell you what. I will talk to the committee and see if I can get them to get it out of committee on Monday and get it to the floor Tuesday morning.
Well, Harry, you're running this game, so why don't you just get it done?
All right, sir. I will get back to you on that. He just hung up calls. Whenever he was done with the business of the call, he just hung up the call. And I'm going to make it there. You never got any like, okay, see you later, thank you, goodbye. Never said goodbye. You would whatever, you'd be in the conversation when he felt the conversation was over.
Boom.
Boom.
Yeah, and Obama said he even did that to him when he was president.
Yeah, he did it to everybody because it wasn't mean. He wasn't being mean, and it wasn't a power thing. That's just the way he was. He didn't go for parties. He didn't go for these extra social niceties that prolong things. He just wanted to get the work done.
That's pretty funny, you think about it. Hanging up on the president?
Yeah. But not hanging up in anger. Hanging up because he felt the conversation had reached its conclusion.
Yeah.
There was no reason for him to be holding the phone to his ear anymore.
Right. Okay, the family of the 14-year-old teenager, or the 14-year-old girl killed in North Hollywood at the Burlington store, had a news conference yesterday, and they said a couple of things. One thing they said, through interpreter, her dad said that the LAPD assassinated his daughter. Now, the mother was a little more less inflammatory by saying that, you know, the girl died in her arms, and they're really devastated.
I have to wonder, and I really am just wondering, this is not code for I know what I'm about to say I'm wondering about is true. I really don't. But they were there with their attorney, right? Benjamin Crump?
Yes, but from my understanding, Benjamin Crump arrived, like, at the last minute. So he likely didn't lean over and say, "Say, assassinated."
Yes, but it's not the first time they ever met or spoke about the matter.
Probably.
So I'm wondering whether the degree of the rhetoric is partially a result of whatever their attorney is telling them as they talk about this. I'm not saying that he would go, and then when you get out there, say that they assassinated your daughter. But that in the talks about it, he might be saying to them, yes, they assassinated your daughter, and we're going to get you justice, and maybe they're echoing, the father's echoing rhetoric that he's hearing, because it would be the place of an attorney to use.
Okay,
even inflammatory rhetoric. It's not specific to Ben Crump. I mean, this is what attorneys do in situations like this.
Looking for a payout.
I mean, you don't want
his job.
Everybody understands that that's not what happened.
Right.
Although, and we are going to get into this at 7:30. Yesterday I had not had a chance to watch the video package.
Yeah,
I
really did it.
Of course, after the show I watched. LAPD is going to have a big problem dealing with this, I assume, a wrongful death lawsuit. And I don't know if they're also going to have a big problem in terms of the police commission and ruling whether this was in or out of policy. But
your understanding of what happened is very different once you see the video. And we'll talk about that at 7:30. But now, a news update from Chris Little. This is KFI AM 640, live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app. All right, Wayne, several women have had revealing videos of them secretly recorded by a guy in Ventura County.
Deputies found a man who took his phone after a woman he allegedly recorded in a mall restroom took a photo of him. Ventura County Sheriff Captain Don Aguilar says detectives found several videos of women using the restroom on his phone.
In addition, Cardona has several slow motion videos captured of females walking and stopping at various stores. Some of the videos were footage recorded underneath female skirts.
Aguilar says the videos were possibly taken in Ventura and L.A. County. He says deputies arrested the man. Blake Trolley, KFI News.
News brought to you by Cunning Dental Group. A man's been sentenced to 35 years to life for killing a woman during an argument over the 2016 election. Prosecutors say the guy pulled a gun after he was teased for saying he voted for Hillary Clinton. When he was asked to leave the house in Long Beach, he shot and killed the woman as she held her two-year-old son on her lap. The World Health Organization says the number of COVID-19 cases recorded worldwide has increased by 11% last week with comparisons of the previous week. From the Southern California Toyota Dealers Traffic Center, we make it easy. We've got a problem, I think, on the 605.
Well, no kind of a problem, but not too serious to you if you're coming down from the 210. The drive is good, really. Speeds are good. Price, 210 to 60. The problem is a little bit south of Beverly Boulevard, over to the shoulder, so just be careful if you're in the right lane. We kept going, too. Last report, I spoke about a possible problem, West 91 to 605. That's a shoulder deal as well, so if you're on Buena Park right now, you're going to head all the way over to Gardena. The drive is good, really. Westbound 91 looking good. Right now we're turning north on the 710, which initially, boy, looks pretty good. However, what we're headed for is another reported problem by CHP. We just got rid of it. The westbound San Bernardino freeway around Soto, that's close to the I-510 interchange. So I'll check on that for you, and let's keep it nice and quiet here. Injured in an accident, visit Superwoman, Superwire.com. Jump AFI in the sky.
If you own a business and manage to keep five or more people on the payroll through the pandemic, there's a new government program that will pay you tens of thousands of dollars per employee. And this is not a loan. This is a grant. The challenge is getting your hands on this money. This is a bureaucracy. InnovationRefunds.com cuts through the red tape, helps you get the cash. They do all of the legwork. They don't charge a penny until you receive the money. And what they do is simply share a percentage of the money they get for you. They got my business a six-figure refund. Now, their average client gets $250,000. That's impressive. Go to InnovationRefunds.com, click on the Qualifying Me button, answer a few questions. InnovationRefunds.com, it's no risk, and it certainly is high reward. InnovationRefunds.com, they help me, I'm sure they can help you. InnovationRefunds.com.
Rail air conditioning is contractor license number 1047-781. This is Ken Goodman for Ghetto Air Conditioning and Fun.
You've already heard the story of how my dad asked me to hold the flashlight for him at night while he worked on air conditioning. Dad knew he was dying, but I didn't. You know the story. Anyway, one of the things Dad would have me do is replace all the screws the previous repair guys left out when they reassembled the unit. My job was to find every missing screw and replace it with a brand new one. I still do that today, and so do all my guys. When motors are whirling and compressors are compressing and electrical contacts are doing their thing, those non-stop vibrations caused by missing screws will cause your system to die long before it's time. That's why we tied your unit down to factory fresh condition on every service call. My guys are professionals. No sweet drivers at home. And don't forget our awesome duct testing. Get it. GOE-TCL. It'll keep you cool, but it's hard to spell. Call it.
Screw back infection affords plenty to worry about. Call help now with free COVID-19 emotional support. Call 833-317-4673 or live chat at callhope.org today.
And Mario Lopez here wishing you a very safe and happy holidays and your COVID cases on the rise. Make sure you're doing your part to help reduce the spread this holiday season. Getting tested is super easy at COVID clinics.
So just go to covidclinic.org to book an appointment at no cost to the patient. They have multiple locations nearby, so visit covidclinic.org to find one near you at covidclinic.org and happy holidays.
Do you think it's okay to drive stoned? The truth is, your reaction times slow way down when you're high. You not only put yourself in danger, but everyone around you. If you've been using marijuana in any form, do not get behind the wheel. If you feel different, you drive different. Drive high. Get a DUI. Paid for by yourself.
For official rules and more information about contacts on this station,
go to KFIAM640.com/rules.
KFI AM 640, live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app. Good morning, Bill Handel Show. He's off this week, back on Monday. Let's continue Handle on the News. Chris Little is here, in for Jennifer Jones Lee.
All right, Wayne, California has become the first state to top 5 million COVID-19 cases.
We're also the most populous state.
So I'm going to say that. I
not stop at you.
I know. And I just had a pause, and you said exactly what I was thinking. We are the most populous, and cases really, I mean, they count, but they really don't count. What counts is California has reported more than 75,000 deaths related to COVID-19. And people are starting to fill up the hospitals. Those are things that are relevant.
Yeah.
Those are things that affect greater society.
Sure.
And I don't have a calculator right in front of me. I'm not going to do it on the air, but I'd like to go through each state and do a per capita case rate and see where we went.
Probably low.
I mean, if you say California has the highest per capita infection rate, I would say, oh, that says something about what's going on.
Yeah, and we in the media make, I think that's a mistake, really, to say, to do this headline. It's the first to top 5 million COVID cases. Well, it is a milestone out of the 50 states, yes, but really when you're talking to people, like we are, it doesn't really give them a perspective.
Are we also the state with the most people who have recovered from COVID?
It's most likely.
So how come we're not reporting that?
Right.
You must be really frustrated, and I'll tell you, I share it a little bit, because if it were totally up to me, I would never, ever talk about just how many cases have been reported, ever.
Well,
it would be no more relevant than talking about what Barbara Ferrer wore to the latest press conference. Yeah, and yet you can't escape it.
Right.
If you're sometimes putting this aside for a second, and you're in a managerial position as well, if there's just some thing
that even if you don't believe
their news or important news, you have to report them because of a certain prevalence of the issue in society, and that you were something's wrong with your news department if you're not addressing. I think that the audience, I mean, so the short answer is yes. But the audience, I think, feels like we're not informing them because they hear this stuff elsewhere. Or somebody might say, hey, this is not our job, really, is to give people water cooler fodder, but at the same time, not cause panic and disinformation and misinformation. Should we be reporting it? I agree with you. It doesn't do anybody any good, except that it makes them smarter for party. Part of our function, seriously, as a New York station, and to have these discussions. And we also have these discussions in the newsroom. We made a decision, actually, that we would not cover cases. But occasionally they slip through and we cover cases. All right. Oh, the Holiday Bowl. One of 15,000.
No, no.
Sorry.
Robert.